On today's episode, I'm going to print really tiny on an Ender 3, and I'll show you a setting in Cura for getting more detail from a 0.4 nozzle, right here on Filament Friday. Filament Friday is brought to you by these Patreon supporters. I found this Curse of the Black Pearl coin on Thingiverse, and I wanted to print it out. I shrunk it down to like 50% of the original size, which made these thin walls really thin. And the teeth and around the mouth, I knew this would probably be a problem. But I was going to try it with a 0.4 nozzle, 25% infill with my magic 0.2 layer height. And just as I suspected, the mouth was missing parts. The ring around the skull was completely gone. And then some of the curls around the edges were missing pieces. Actually, it did a better job than I initially thought. When I printed it, it did not look bad, but those details were missing. Then I remembered there's a print thin wall setting. It's for models which are horizontally thinner than the nozzle size. So you just enable that and reslice. And when I did that, all the mouth appeared. The ring around the skull appeared, although it looked just a little bit sketchy, but it's there. And then the details on the loops actually look better too. And here's the print. It looks a lot better. Now the print itself doesn't look any better, but the details are there. In fact, the print's a little bit rougher. So then I decided, why don't I just change the line width too? The line width is what the slicer tries to produce coming out of the nozzle. So it should match the nozzle, but you can actually go a little bit smaller. So I went down to a 0.3, and when I sliced it, it printed all that detail, but it didn't look a whole lot different because I still had the thin wall setting on. So some of the detail was a little bit thicker, but not a major difference. Then I decided to go all the way and adjust it down to 0.2. Now Cura goes orange here to tell me that this is like a violation. It's not what they recommend. But when I sliced it, the wall around the skeleton was much thicker. Some of the detail looked better. So I decided to just print it and see what happened. Now the print is kind of rough, so the flow isn't right, but it did print all that detail, just kind of like the slicer said it would. So then I figured I'd just go all the way and change the nozzle. So I'm going to try a 0.3 nozzle first. Within Cura, from the drop-down menu, I chose a 0.3 nozzle and then changed all the line widths to match. And then when I sliced it, it looked like the 0.3 I did before, but now maybe it'll print different with an actual 0.3 nozzle. So this one I decided to print, even though I didn't print it before, and this is the way it looked. Not too bad. I wouldn't say this is great because I don't have the flow settings right for a 0.3 nozzle. Then I decided to go 0.2. And the 0.2 layer height is now a warning with a 0.2 nozzle, which is right. But slicer-wise, it looked as good as the 0.4 with that thin wall setting. But what about the actual print quality? So I printed it, and here's the result. And I got to tell you, the flow is terrible here. It's looking worse. So my profile is not working with the smaller nozzles. I would have to adjust everything again. And then just for fun, I brought in a benchy and I shrunk it down to 25% of its original size. So it's really, really small. And since I had the 0.2 nozzle, even though it's not flowing right, I decided to just print one using that. And then I'm going to use a 0.4 nozzle and follow it up. Now, I thought the slicer would tell me, you know, parts of it aren't going to print, but it looked like the whole thing would print. So then I made a profile with the 0.4 as well. Everything 0.4, thin wall, and slice that. Now this looks a little rougher than the 0.2. The smokestack looks rougher. There's parts of it that just are, I don't know, sketchy. But it's going to be fun to compare these two, print the two and see how they come out. I honestly was thinking these would look like absolute garbage. I was shocked how good they looked. Now granted, these aren't great prints, but look at this. Compared to a size of an American dime, they're smaller and they both printed 0.4 on the left, 0.2 on the right. Neither is a great print, but I'm amazed how good these are. They're smaller or about the same size as the nozzle that printed them. And compared to a regular size benchy, they're like grandchildren. So this was a lot of fun, and I'm really shocked how good it printed.
After trying out that setting, I'm really impressed with how well a 0.4 nozzle prints on an Ender 3. And in fact, I did not think these benches would come out. When I started this, I thought I'd actually get blobs. To get this much detail from a 0.4 nozzle on an Ender 3, I'm really impressed. In fact, you could print your own Monopoly pieces with this and they'd be acceptable. Now, I know I didn't show you how to get really good prints with a 0.2 nozzle, but the fact is I tried a lot of different settings. I even tried other people's profiles and I couldn't get much better than I was getting with the 0.4 in that thin wall setting. So if I need better prints than this, I'd probably go with one of those low-cost resin printers. You can get one of those for about $300-$400, and it'll print a lot better than this. But for most jobs where I have to print a little gear or a little knob or something, or just some fine detail, a 0.4 nozzle with that thin wall setting, I think it's going to cover about 90% of what I need.